Hey guys, I want to introduce you to Alex.
My name's Alex Dainis, and I'm a genetics PhD student and a science vlogger.
And she has a really great YouTube channel that you really need to go check out. Here's a taste.
What if you could store all of the world's data in the back of a car?
What is this thing?
What is this thing? What is this thing?
I can also wear it as a science cape, very in this fall.
I took them back to the lab and took careful samples of the fruit. Break open cells, get DNA, wash DNA. And it worked. Nothing in lab ever works on the first try.
And that's Alex.
Today, we're going to be talking about micellar water.
We love it.
We do. We both love this stuff, and it's gained a lot of popularity recently. And why? Well, for me, it's because it's convenient. It is a 3-in-1 product that removes makeup, cleanses the face, and leaves you feeling hydrated and refreshed.
I love it because it's super portable, so I can throw it into my gym bag or a backpack and go, go, go.
So this stuff is great, but how does it work?
Well, according to the product, it is Micellar Technology. Woo! Spoiler alert, Micellar Technology is nothing new. It's been around for a really long time. In fact, if you've ever combined water, soap, or detergent, you've been using Micellar Technology.
That's right, cutting-edge Babylonian technology straight out of 2800 BC.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So what is this stuff anyways?
Micelles are these clusters or spheres of detergent molecules. The role of a detergent molecule is to clean, and micelles do that by trapping dirt and oil. So in here, there's a bunch of micelles floating around, but you can't see them, and that's because they are submicroscopic, meaning they're even hard to see with an ordinary visible light microscope.
But they are in there. If we shine a beam of light through both water and micellar water, you'll notice that the beam of light is wider and more intense when it goes through the micellar water. This is because the beam is hitting those micelles and they are scattering the light. This is called the Tyndall effect, and it allows us to see those submicroscopic particles.
So that's the same effect that you see on a foggy night when the beams of a car's headlights become visible.
It is, exactly. So what makes these detergent molecules special?
Well, if I were to pluck a detergent molecule from a micelle, I would have a really tiny hand. But the second thing is that I would have a molecular structure with two opposing chemical tendencies. It would have a hydrophilic head that loves water and a hydrophobic tail that fears water and favors oil. So if I were to take some of this micellar water and pour it onto a cotton pad, the micelle would break apart and the water-loving heads would orient themselves to the water-saturated cotton pad. The water-fearing tails, they'll want to be as far away from that water as possible. So they'll point in the opposite direction, towards the air. When we bring that cotton pad to our face, those tails that favor oil are going to surround the dirt and oil on our skin and trap it, where we'll remove it away with that cotton pad.
But these hydrophobic tails can only pick up so much dirt and oil at a time, which is why you might have to repeat this process depending on just how dirty your face is. So, is this just soapy water?
Well, there is a lot of soapy water in it, but there are other qualities that make it a really great product. For example, they use milder detergents. So there's a lot of factors that go into mildness, but one of them is the size of the micelle. So larger micelles are milder and less irritating. Irritation can be caused by micelles that can disrupt the upper layer of skin. Mm-hmm. To put that in perspective, something like an adult shampoo is gonna be about 3 nanometers, and something like a baby shampoo or a mild facial cleanser will have a much bigger micelle in the 6 to 8 nanometer range. So this is gonna be much more difficult to get in and disrupt the skin.
Makes sense.
Another thing is that they use less detergent. Mm. So a typical cleansing formulation is gonna have anywhere from 10 to 30% detergent, but micellar water uses a lot less. I would say around 5%.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So if you combine having a milder detergent with having less of it, this is why you can leave the product on your face without irritation.
Exactly. Glad somebody's paying attention.
I see. All right. Now, I've also noticed that these have humectants in them, which are products that actually attract moisture to your face.
They do. They bring a lot of moisture in.
Yes, leave you feeling lovely and refreshed. And I've noticed that there are even more humectants in these than there are detergents.
You're really good at reading these product labels. So yeah, one of the most common humectants in micellar water that I've noticed is hexylene glycol and propylene glycol. And the formulation actually is very similar to baby wipes.
Oh.
So if you think about baby wipes, they're super mild, they are non-irritating, and they use less detergent. And that's why you can leave it on a baby's sensitive skin.
Oh.
So I thought we would end this video by doing a challenge.
Yay!
Baby wipes versus micellar water. Which one's better, and can you tell the difference? All right, here we go. Okay, so,
So this one felt a little bit softer, a little bit more creamy. So I think I'm gonna go with this one being the baby wipe.
Okay.
And this is the micellar water.
Oh my God, she guessed it. You are so good. Oh, she killed this challenge.
So. I gotta tell you, they were very, very close, but I have used many of these micellar waters before, so I might just be a micellar water connoisseur.
Thank you so much for participating in this video. I really appreciate it. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. And if you have questions about micellar water, either for myself or for Alex, put them in the comment section below. And you should totally check out Alex's channel.
We made a video about the genetics behind freckles, and you can check that out by clicking the link right over here.